When the finance minister admitted the exchequer's finances, at least the public finances for public services are under strain. Indirect tax collections have risen by nearly 37% in October. Not just that, but this fiscal so far, tax collections are higher by about 36% when compared to last fiscal. But here's the kicker. This remarkable rise is thanks to additional duties like the oil cess that was levied by the centre and the withdrawal of exemptions like, for example, on the auto sector. Without all of that, taxes, indirect tax collections have grown by just over 11% when compared to last year. Let's discuss this a little more. Rajeev Dimri, the partner at BMR, now joining us live. Thanks, Rajeev, for joining us here on WhatsApp. My first question to you, you know, indirect tax collections, the finance ministry, the tax department saying are picking up at a very healthy pace. For example, customs has already achieved 58.8% of the budget estimate, central excise 64.7%, service tax 53.7%, a total therefore an average at 59.2%. So if indeed the indirect tax collections are so healthy, where, you know, the exchequer might actually meet more than what he had targeted, why the new oil cess? Why this Swachh Bharat cess?
Well, I first and foremost, this is great news that, you know, indirect taxes, high collection actually means that there is that many goods being produced in the economy. So it's always a very direct measure of what's happening on the ground, and therefore it's a good sign. It's a great news. Hmm. I personally would delink high tax collection or low tax collection from a particular tax like Swachh Bharat tax, because that's not meant to be a revenue of the government of India. It is a levy for a very specific purpose, which is for Clean India. And I think the rationale for that tax, which was already announced in the budget, one could question whether November 15th is the right date, should it have been, a different date. Barring that conversation, I think that levy of this tax is on a different footing and therefore can't be compared that if you are doing well on tax collection, do I need this tax? So to me,
but Rajeev, one can't help wondering that supposing the government had been at least better on track as far as this disinvestment pipeline goes, maybe we wouldn't have seen the levy of this Swachh Bharat cess. Maybe we wouldn't have seen the latest oil cess also over the weekend.
See, oil cess is on a different footing. To me, Swachh Bharat was a tax that was announced. It has now been activated. And one has to look at Swachh Bharat cess on a 3 to 5 years as to what, will eventually happen out of it. How will it actually help in, the pet project of the government, in Clean India, in, improving sanitation and other things. And if it actually gets, used for that, hopefully the taxpayers will see a direct outcome of this money that they're spending. Oil cess is more, on account of if there are reduced prices on international market, can they use that reduction to augment their revenues? So there could be a very different logic for the two different taxes.
But all of this is also happening and hurting the consumer, Rajeev. And this is the point I want to ask you about. You've also, for example, had that airport, the airline cess for, better regional connectivity. You have the latest oil cess. You have the Swachh Bharat cess. Consumption has not picked up. This Diwali has been rather lackluster. Are you happy with what the finance ministry is doing? Or do you think the need of the hour might have been some out-of-the-box thinking to boost revenues?
Well, I don't know whether they're doing this. So, yes, any new tax and particularly these cesses, because, our past history has not been great about actual usage of these funds as a country. And therefore, one does look at these things with a little bit of cynicism. I don't know whether the thought process around is that let's give the bad news now and when the budget comes up, because this government is now in the budget mode. There are active conversations going on. There is a thought process around the budget. So maybe you start doing these things now so that at the budget time, perhaps there might be some good news. I'm only speculating.
How is all of this, Rajeev, going to play out? Because we're also at a stage where the government says it's so serious about the goods and services tax, and you're getting all this, you're getting higher indirect tax collection, and you're getting all of these kind of levies, be it the oil levy, be it the Swachh Bharat levy, be it for the airports connectivity. How is all of this going to pan out together?
Well, at least the higher tax collection, and the word out there is that this comfortable collection will actually help them expedite some of the pending refunds. I mean, there has been huge pendency on refunds, particularly in the, on the indirect tax side, and even more particularly on the service tax exports. And these have now piled up to some very large numbers for corporates. And somewhere there is a thought process that, you know, let's use this comfortable collection to expedite those refunds. That also, in a sense, cleans up the transition to GST, because you're not carrying over this legacy into a GST environment. And actually, on the ground, in the last 4, 5, 6 weeks, I do get a sense that the refund process has improved somewhat. And if that momentum continues, I think that could be a huge relief to the corporates, where for years they have money stuck in service tax refunds.
That's a big headline that you're giving us, that the tax department is expediting service tax refunds to corporates. But once again, doesn't that not bring us the same question? Is it going to bring the fisc under more pressure?
Well, if the service tax refunds come in, that money goes directly to the corporates, it improves the cash position, and certainly is a huge, you know, welcome in times of you know, such needs, where everybody starved for cash. When it comes to cesses, it always gets passed on to the consumer. So the two scenarios are impacting two different classes of people. The Swachh Bharat cess is something that you and I will see on our telecom bills or on everything that we'll be paying. Hopefully, 0.5% is a lot better than 2% that was the original proposal. And maybe, you know, it won't pinch as much as 2% would have. So that's something that's going to impact you and I as a consumer. But if indeed the momentum of refunds, particularly service tax refunds, continue, then the corporates will directly get the benefit in terms of, you know, cash flow that has been stuck for a long period of time, suddenly getting released. So the impact is very different. The Swachh Bharat says is, will it impact consumer behavior? Will you start consuming less? Will you start making less phone calls? Will you start going, you know, will you replace your entertainment or whatever? I doubt that 0.5% will have that impact.
Okay, yeah, but you do have the service tax rate going up to 14.5%. Rajeev Dimri, always a pleasure to have you on CNBC TV 18. Thank you for taking the time out. There's BMR giving us a big headline that the tax department has started expediting service tax refunds to corporates in anticipation of the GST, using the cushion from the higher indirect tax collections. With